Hello, welcome to the Monday, July 9th, 2018 edition of the Sands Unit Storm Center's Stormcast. My name is Johannes Ulrich and today I'm recording from Jacksonville, Florida. If you are using Hewlett-Packard servers that are equipped with the integrated Lights Out 4 board, that's HP ILO 4, these are these boards that allow you to access the computer and reboot it and power cycle it. Well, last August, HP released an update for the firmware on these boards, and it turns out that we now have a trivial authentication bypass exploit against a vulnerability that was patched last August. Now, back then, HP didn't really make a big deal about this update, so you may have missed it. All you need to do on affected cards to bypass authentication is add a connection header to your HTTP requests that contains 29 letters A. So very trivial, with simple tools like curl and such, you can easily send requests like this and gain access to a server. Now, even before you patch this, I would double check and make sure that you do not expose any of these interfaces to the outside world. Based on past experience, there are probably more vulnerabilities that haven't been patched yet in these interfaces. And of course, there's always the risk of weak passwords. So make sure you don't allow access to these interfaces from anything but specific IP addresses, and then make sure that they are patched. Over the last year, we have seen this marked shift from ransomware to cryptojacking, and looks like the latest piece of ransomware to join this trend is the Rackne family. Now, this particular family of ransomware has been around since at least 2013, and as discovered now by Kaspersky, this ransomware now added cryptojacking to its toolset. Now, they're however doing it with a little spin. By default, the ransomware still does what it does best. It encrypts your files. But if you do have more than two logical CPUs, then it will actually instead use these CPUs for crypto coin mining. It also has sort of a third mode where it really just spreads to other systems. The ransomware itself arrives as a PDF. Now, Kaspersky published the Russian version of it. Not really clear if there are other language versions of this going around as well. And in the past, we have seen occasional reports about vulnerabilities in gas stations. Typically, this relates to admin interfaces and such for the gas pumps being exposed. Now, looks like some attackers now managed to actually exploit some of these vulnerabilities. At this point, it's not really clear what vulnerability they exploited. The news report here is talking about a device they used in order to wrestle control over the gas pump from the tenant, and then they used it to fill up at least 10 different cars, stealing about 600 gallons of gasoline valued at about $1,800. And it looks like something very similar happened a few days earlier in Detroit, and in this case, actually, a particular individual was caught and accused of using some sort of device to steal $800 worth of gas from a gas station. Now, in this second case, he actually did it after hours, so there was no attendant there to actually trying to stop him. In the first case, the attendant then in the end just used the emergency shutoff in order to cut off fuel to the pumps, so at least that part was still working. Well, and that's it for today, so thanks for listening, and talk to you again tomorrow. Bye.